day off before the last week before holidays, which I'm really excited about. I have been living alone for all of those previous 2 weeks because my flatmate went on holidays and I got really used to it. It's so nice to live by herself and I don't want her back. Because it's super comfortable to have your own place in London. But I understand it's a big luxury, and who I am at the end of the day. An artist. Hypnotized by the sun outside. It's super weird to see sunlight. Yesterday, I had this little reflection on life. Because we're adults, we've got to reflect on things. And then I thought to myself, the second half of my previous season in my previous company, I would say that was one of the best times in my career as a ballet dancer. Because I've really done loads of stuff and I've done a lot of work and I survived a really busy schedule and loads of productions and I kept on being healthy and strong and everything was fine. And then I was trying to question the universe. Why? Why all of a sudden when I get the taste of success and try to move places, which is London, every day becomes a challenge. Like basically that last half of the previous season in my previous company, I had this mindset that whatever happens, I was still ambitious, but I didn't have any specific goals set. And I was quite chill about every day. I mean, every day was quite difficult because we've had loads of things every month, basically, lots of activities and lots of challenges for me as an artist. But I think the main thing was that I didn't have the end goal. I was kind of seeing what every day has for me, if that makes sense. And I was just trying to survive and make the most out of it, out of each opportunity. When here, I came here for a very specific reason. I've got to be honest. I don't have any passion to live in London or to experience it. Neither I love it physically, like in an aesthetic way. And therefore it's quite obvious for me that I came here for a really obvious and specific reason to achieve my ballet goals. But as soon as I set them and made them really specific for myself and literally named them, explosion total. Nothing was going as planned. And I think I focused so much on like the fact that yes, I have this goal and I am an unstoppable I'm a Porsche with no brakes and stuff, which doesn't really make sense because if there are such things as manifestation and stuff where you have to really specify your wishes and desires and they should come to you after you really think about them for a long time, when in my case, that's completely the opposite. Once I formed a very specific desire and a wish, everything started to dissolve around me. So yeah, that's just some thoughts that I had and I was trying to find the reason and justify all of this bad luck, let's say, that I had to face at the end of 2023. And I think those unfortunate events kind of taught me that calm down a little bit and expect nothing. I have multiple missions to complete today, including going to add electricity. I'm not familiar with this kind of a system. Like, I need to take some key and then go to a store to fill it and then come back here and put it in some kind of a machine or something. Then I am also supposed to clean my flat today because I've been living by myself for 2 weeks, and my flatmate, let's call her Coco because we don't want to reveal her personality, her identity. So I've been creating this comfort, relaxing environment for myself, but it not necessarily means that it's gonna be a nice environment for her, because, you know, I'm an autist, nobody understands me. Okay, so I think I have to fill this thing, top up, I think in English you say top up, and yeah, I love being an adult. We'll see what this experience brings to us. I did the thing. Wasn't that complicated, actually. So he knows how to do the electricity now. Yeah, I'm a bit of a functional freeze mode at the moment. Like, I can take care of myself and keep myself alive, but it's a bit difficult. But I'm excited to be in Lithuania soon, so that's really nice. That was nice.
because every time it starts all nice and wholesome and sweet and logical, you know, like natural flow of events, normal sequences of shots and stuff. And then it just gets creepy at some point. And the question is, do we follow the socially acceptable paths and keep it chill and play along the rules of the genre? Or we go authentic. See, that's always the question. Like, fitting the social stereotypes or being yourself, but risking to be judged.